Hey everyone, in this video, we're gonna show you 5 tips on how to dance confidently in your wedding dress or ball gown or whatever long evening dress you have.
And for you leads out there, these tips will apply to you so that you or your lovely partner don't trip on that dress.
Yes. Are you struggling with learning how to dance together?
Yep, and you'd rather follow a proven method that's helped hundreds of couples learn how to dance confidently and authentically together?
Well, stay till the end to find out how you can work with both Joel and Clara directly.
And in the meantime, make sure that you hit that like, that subscribe, and the notification bell down below so that you know when Joel and Clara post a new video that helps you learn lifelong skills for the dance floor.
Now let's get started. Tip number 1 is all about the dress. How to get it out of the way so that you don't trip on it.
Exactly.
So here I have a bed sheet on to show you.
Very nice, Clara.
Thank you. And often, especially for wedding dresses, but some evening dresses as well, will have a train. Mm-hmm. So what you can do is go to a dressmaker and have a bustle done. Mm-hmm. So that's where they'll sew a little loop or two onto the dress, and then they'll hook it up to a bead or something on the dress, sort of hidden there so nobody really sees it. And that gets it to a floor length, so it's much easier to dance in. Mm-hmm. As well, another alternative is if you have the train there and you don't want to bustle, you can also, like the olden days in the movies, do a little elastic around the wrist and then hook it on your wrist so that you can just almost like carry it as you're dancing.
Exactly. Making sure that you do that on the lady's left side and not her right side, because the right side is usually used for underarm turns and we just don't want to get caught up and tangled in the train when it's on the lady's right side.
Definitely. Tip number 2. A lot of you, especially if you're getting married, don't want to show your groom the wedding dress. Mm-hmm. So tip number 2 is put on a bed sheet.
Exactly.
I didn't feel like getting into my wedding dress today either, so so I just wrapped myself up in a bed sheet and made it floor length, which is more kind of probably realistic to what you're going to be wearing.
Exactly. And gentlemen, I loaned my lovely partner Clara my belt just so that the bed sheet stays up.
Yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. One thing also for leads is that you should practice with pants or trousers that you're going to be wearing at the wedding. I mean, usually we're pretty not so discreet about what we're gonna wear, so it's easy to be able to practice at home with it. And the main reason for that is, especially if you're planning to do any dips or leans, you just wanna make sure that you've got enough space to be able to do that.
Yes, you need to know how low can you go.
Exactly, otherwise, oops, there might be a little surprise at the end of your dip.
So once you've got that bed sheet on, tip number 3 is to slide your feet.
Exactly. We don't want to be getting ourselves stepping on the dress and tripping. And therefore, whether we are a lead or follow, we want to practice dancing with our feet, always touching the ground.
That's right. Especially when we're going backwards, we don't want to pick up our foot and then step on the dress. So this would be me, an example of me picking up my foot. And then I've already stepped on it.
Exactly. Yeah.
So just keep on sliding. Mm-hmm.
And usually what will end up happening, especially now for us leads when we're sliding our feet, is that our foot can actually now slide underneath. I mean, my toe is just underneath there, but you can see how it slides underneath Clara's dress or bed sheet.
Bed sheet's a little tight, so sometimes the dress will be a little poofier than this.
Exactly. And then that's totally fine because again, we're not stepping on top of it. Yeah. And as a bonus thing for our leads, we want you to remind yourselves that we are going to try to communicate to the lady to step backwards. Yeah. And that way she and her dress will start moving backwards away from you. And then we've talked about this in previous videos, but we just want to be clear that the body goes and then the foot will go.
And yeah? That'll also avoid stepping on the dress.
Yes. Versus now my foot going first, boom. Now, all I have is a bunch of dress to step on, and Clara's not going backwards.
That's right. So, ladies, as soon as you feel that body weight coming towards you, then you start sliding out that foot.
Before we go into tips 4 and 5 of this video, we want to thank Emily and Denny, 2 people who have asked us how to dance in dresses in previous video comments.
Let us know which of these 5 tips hit home for you. And if you have any other questions, if you would like us to make videos on any other tips, let us know in the comments below. Tip number 4 is to always try and walk forwards. especially when you're turning.
Exactly. Now, leads, we have a lot of control over whether or not our partner goes forwards or backwards. So I'd like to talk to you guys first. Here, I'm gonna lead Clara into an underarm turn. And as she does, I am trying to lead her as best as possible to keep walking forwards in her dress.
Yeah? That's right. Always avoid walking backwards because that's when the tripping hazard.
Yeah, let's just see what that looks like. So I'm gonna lead Clara with the underarm turn. And as I'm about to complete, I start to now pull her backwards.
And I'm already stepping on the dress.
So gentlemen, if you see, I started it nicely, but then I prematurely pulled it back and made Clara go backwards at the end of that.
That's right. In a previous video that we were working on spins, we remember that you have to do a little halo over the lady's head so that she keeps on walking forward.
Exactly, exactly. And the more safe thing is to make that halo as round as possible at the very end before we get ourselves back together.
That's right.
Okay, don't cut it through the halo and only half of a halo and then bring it back.
That'll allow the ladies to keep on walking forwards instead of backwards. Tip number five is flick the dress. So if you have a lot of fabric in your dress, sometimes you get a little trapped in it as you're turning.
Yeah, it's like a corkscrew that just keeps on going.
Yes, I mean, this isn't very, showing the huge amount of fabric, but just imagine that I have this huge dress, a lot of fabric. So as I'm doing the turn, I'm gonna pick up the skirt and then pick it up and flick it a little bit as I'm turning.
Exactly. It gets that dress moving with you instead of being on the spot and you moving
and twisted all around you. Exactly. Sometimes you get trapped in there. So definitely if you have a lot of fabric, pick it up and flick it as you're turning.
It actually has a nice effect and it gives that extra motion for videos and pictures, which is an added bonus.
Yeah.
Also for the guys, when we are leading your partner and you know that she needs to flick her dress, give her time to find her dress before you start leading her into the underarm turn. So say for instance, here I am with Clara, we've already separated out. Instead of me just going straight away and leading her, I need to give her a little bit more time to find her dress, boom, and then we can get ourselves started with an underarm turn.
Yeah.
So just be aware that that little action needs to happen before the other fancy stuff like spins, rotations, or whatever else you're going to be leading your partner to do.
Before you go, here's a bonus tip for you wedding couples out there. Make sure you practice before the reception.
Exactly. A lot of times couples will have their ceremony, then a little break where they go off with the photographer, take some photos, and then head over to the reception afterwards.
This is the perfect opportunity to practice in the actual attire that you're gonna be wearing. And at the same time, you might get some cool photos.
Do you find yourself still struggling dancing with a partner or totally stressed out about the mere thought of dancing in front of other people?
And you wanna build lifelong dance skills so that you can be confident dancing at your next wedding or social event?
Well, we can help you with that.
Our system has helped hundreds of couples go from awkward and reluctant to get onto the dance floor to actually feeling confident and looking forward to getting on the dance floor.
So if that sounds interesting to you, set up a free consultation call with Joel and Clara. The link is down in the description below.
In the meantime, if you'd like a free wedding dance checklist, check out our download down in the description below.
Thanks very much again for watching, you guys. Make sure you like, subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you guys know whenever Joel and Clara post a new video for you guys.
Bye.